Welcome back. This is the part C of a three video series. In this series, we are talking about convolution. In part A, we will discuss matrix multiplication methods, review image file structure, prepare a simple image data set, create a filter, in other words, kernel for plus shape. Then, in part B, we will talk about convolution as element-wise matrix multiplication and summation. And we are gonna test the algorithm with different images. In part C, I'm going to specifically talk about convolution to the layer. We are gonna apply the convolution onto an image with a larger size than the filters. Understand stride and padding. Formalize all these processes. Investigate Keras convolution two-dimensional layer, and we are gonna integrate all we learned so far with Keras convolution 2D layer.
Before starting today's topic, I would like to introduce my channel. At Murat Karakaya Academy channel, I will share content especially about machine learning in English and in Turkish. If you are interested in artificial intelligence or machine learning, and if you are looking for theoretical and practical information, please subscribe to my channel and activate notifications. Now, let's continue with today's topic.
If you check out the convolution 2D layer documentation, you would see that convolution 2D function takes lots of parameters. Actually, several of them are very important for a programmer view. So, these are filters, kernel size, strides, padding, and use bias. In previous videos, we already talked about how to implement the convolution in Python. In this video, we are gonna relate the previous video's information with the Keras layers convolution 2D. Filters. Previous video, we already created a filter by ourselves manually. And in that filter, we are looking for a plus shape. You might remember that we created the filter manually, 8x8 size. And we put the ones and minus ones according to the shape. Here, the parameter fields determines the number of the filters. In our example, so far we use only one filter and apply this filter to the image by just using the star operator in Python, so which is element-wise matrix multiplication. In real life, we can use lots of filters to apply this. And in our video, we already mentioned that actually here we created manually. Here we can create lots of filters which can learn from the image according to the given target values, some shapes, some other forms of understanding the images, but the weights or the numbers in the filters are determined by the backpropagation mechanism. The number of the filters here, we are gonna decide. So most of the time, power of 2 is decided. For example, filters could be 32, 64 or so. The next parameter is the kernel size. Actually, kernel size is the filter size. So kernel and filter are the same. You might remember that in our example, we created a plus filter manually and the kernel size 8x8. So the size of the filter or the kernel is called kernel size. Strides. You might remember that in our previous videos, we talked about the strides. So you might remember that the idea is to just rotate the filter over the image. So for each part of the image, we multiply the filter and sum up the numbers into the new feature map, so resulting map. The strides means that how many columns and how many rows we are moving at a time when the image size is larger than the kernel size. So we are providing a tuple of two integers. The first number is for the row, the second number is for the column. Most of the time we use 1, 1. So it means that we are moving the kernel on the image one column at a time and one row at a time. And padding. So you might remember about the padding. We show that first of all in our notebook we apply the padding. Simply, if we are given some matrix, if we are padded with zero, it means that we are adding some zero numbers around the original matrix, which are 2x2. Basically, what we are doing, we are adding first row with zeros, last row with zeros, first column with zeros, and last column with zeros, such that the inputted matrix are surrounded by zeros. Actually, you can do this coding on the one line of code. The padding has two parameters values. One is valid, the other is same. Valid means basically don't use any padding, so use the original matrix. Same means actually add some number of zero paddings such that after the multiplication of the kernel or the convolution, the feature map size will be exactly the same with the inputted image size. We have two filters here. This is the filter one. This is the filter two. As I said before, you can use large number of filters like 32, 64, depending on your application. Each filter will have three dimensions. The first dimensions, the first two dimensions are the height and the width of the given image, and of course last dimension will be the color channels. You might remember from our previous videos, the last channels are for the R, G and B values. You remember that in any image has height and width. Okay, H and width, and with a three channel. So each channel represents the R, the red one, G, green, and B, blue. So you have the H times W times three. So when you create a filter, you need to create filter for each channel as well. So when you create one filter, actually you are creating one filter for the size of 3x3, any kernel size, actually 5x5, 7x5, mostly odd numbers. But for each channel, that's important. So you create for each channel. And you see that this is the filter two. So you create the n by n. And by for each channel. At the end, you end up with some feature maps. You remember that when you apply the element-wise operation multiplication on the input image with the kernel or the filter, you end up with the feature map. This is the feature map. Now you end up actually feature map one, and you have feature map two. What you do? You stack over the feature maps such that now they are two. So that our dimensions will be 4x4. So now the 4x4 comes the first 4x4 here, the second 4x4 matrix here, feature map one and feature map two. So you stack over the third dimension. Now we have the two channels. So if you use, for example, 32 filters, if you use 32 filters, you will end up 4x4x32. I guess you understand all the ideas behind the filters. So when you provide the number of filters, at the end of the operation, convolution operation, you will end up this number of channels as the last dimension. Let's continue. Now, let's talk about stride first. You see that you provide the stride 1-1. It means that at a time one column move and one row move. But before going that, here is the filter is one. So you see that here is the filter only one. Okay. What about the kernel size? Notice that the kernel size here is 3x3. Okay, so this is the filter, one filter, 3x3. And we don't have the, actually you see that the input shape is 6 by 6. It's not 3 dimension. Actually it must be here 6 by 6 and 3 for RGB colors, but for the time being forget it. Now 6 by 6. Okay. So the input size is larger than the filter. What we will do, remember that striding. So strides means that we are moving on the image. We are moving the kernel over the image. One column at a time, one row at a time, because it is given as 1-1. And I will talk padding later. Now just note that padding, well, it means here that we don't add any padding. We don't put zeros around the input. We don't do this because it's what it means, that just use the input. Okay, so you just apply this part of the image, apply this part of the image because it's 3x3 by the filter, and calculate the sum and write the sum here. You notice that this 6x6 image applying 3x3, the resulting feature map, remember this is called feature map, this feature map will be 4x4. Okay, so you notice that when you're using padding, if the image size is larger than the filter size, which is 6x6, 3x3, then the resulting feature map will has less size than the input. Okay, but when this is stride 1 and 1, let's continue. You see that since the stride is 1 1, so at each time we are moving this 3x3 kernel over the image one column at a time, and then when the columns are exhausted, one row at a time. If the stride is 2x2, it means that applying the kernel first here, we are gonna move two columns at a time, and we will apply again here, you see. After finishing all the columns, we are gonna move two rows at a time, and we will apply here. Okay, so that's the strides. Most of the time we are gonna use 1, 1, so 1x1. Okay, but here still notice that since the padding is zero, since the padding is valid, we didn't add any zeros around the given matrix, so the resulting feature map, size is only 2x2, which is very small than the input size, which is 6x6. Filter is still 1, and kernel size is still is here 3x3. Okay, and image dimension is 6x6. Stride is 1x1. It means that just move one column and one row at a time. And the padding is this time not valid, but the same. Same means that to the Keras layer, same means that add necessary number of zero padding around the original input matrix. So that's the original input matrix. If you say padding same, so the algorithm, the Keras layer will try to do add necessary number of paddings around the original matrix such that the resulting feature map, this is the feature map, the resulting feature map will have the exact dimension with the input image dimension. In this example, we only need actually 1 0 padding around the original matrix. With using stride 1 and 1, if you apply these element-wise matrix operation and the summation, when you put the values here, you will end up with 6x6 feature map, which is exactly the same size input. If you change some parameters here, for example, size 2.1 or 1.2, whatever, or 2.2, or if you change the kernel size, for example, 5.5, then maybe the number of zero paddings will be changed. Maybe it's gonna be 2 padding around the original matrix, such that the resulting feature map will exactly be the same size with the input. When you need the output, the feature map dimension needs to be the same with the input, you just write it padding same. If you don't care about it, if you let it get smaller and you don't care about it, then you can put here padding valid. That's the whole idea. Okay, now here you can see the how can we do this again. Assume that the padding is valid, it means that don't use any padding. Okay, image matrix is greater than the feature map will be mapped. Why? Because if you look at that image is 5x5, filter is 3x3, and stride is 1. So what we are going to do, we will apply 3x3 first here, then here, and then here, and we finish. So we can move in the columns only by 3. And similarly, we can apply the first filter here, the next row here, and the last row here. As you see that here, you can move on only 3 times. So the resulting feature map will be 3x3. Okay, which is, you see that, less than the original image. Okay, but if you say the padding is same, so at the end the image matrix size and the feature map size will be the same. Look at that, image map size 5x5 and the feature map size 5x5, and with same, the system will automatically adds necessary number of padding around the original matrix. Here only 1 padding is enough, and when you apply this 3x3 kernel, let's apply, this is the first place, this is the second, this is the third, and this is the fourth, and this is the fifth. So you see that we can add 5 times here on the columns, and if you count, you will see that you will do the same 5 times. You can move on the kernel over these matrix 5. So ending is 5x5, which is exactly the same. If you use the padding with the parameter same value, then you will end up with this. So you see the calculation here as an animation. Actually, you can calculate the output number of height and the width by using some formulas, but I am not happy with this kind of memorization. Just you understand that if you use the padding, okay, same, the result will be the same size with the input image matrix. Okay, if you use the padding with valid, you will not use any padding around it. That's the whole idea in Keras two-dimensional convolution. Actually, I would like to remind you that convolution is not only about matrix multiplication and summation, and other kinds of convolution which are called pooling. For example, here you see a max pooling, and we have only 1 filter. All right, and this filter is actually 2x2 kernel size, but here you see that this image is 4x4, so it still is the stride here. Assume that stride is again 1. Okay, so what you do, that You put your kernel here. Now, in that kernel, we don't have any weights. But what we do is that we don't have any matrix multiplication. We are looking that part of the image and select the maximum number here and write into the feature map. So this is another feature map. So you move on the again. If you put the kernel straight to, now you move on here. Okay. Here you put the 8 here. Since stride is 2 comma less 2, now you move on here, and now 3 is the max you put here, and you move on 2 here, now 4 is here, 4. So this is another kind of convolution pulling. Here you see the max pull. If you want, you can watch my next video about pulling. Okay, after discussing all the related parameters in convolution 2D in Keras, we can now apply these ideas, okay, in our project. Here in our project, remember that we have the some shapes we uploaded now. These are PNG, RGB, and you might remember the 64 by 64 by 3. And we can just input the filters only one for the one. And kernel size, remember that we have the plus filter already created 8 by 8, okay? Now let's run it, alright? Now, image matrix, remember that we have the image matrix already uploaded, now we can normalize it. And here, what I am going to add a one dimension so that it's the batch size for the image. In this time, you see that I am using all the three colors channel. Okay, now I will try to convert two-dimensional filter into three-dimensional by replicating the same plus filter in three dimensions for each color channel. And let me show here that now I have 8 by 3 by 1. So by 1 comes here that we have only one filter, but for each image size 8 by 8 or filter size, kernel size, I have 3 of them, because for each 8 by 8 for one color there are RGB colors. Now we can up these weights and reshape the weights because we have now 3. We have the 8 by 8 and 3 and 1. So 1 is the filter number, 8 by 8 is the kernel size, 3 is for the channel for each weight in the filter. Okay, we have arrived at our TensorFlow Keras Layers Convolution 2D. All right. And remember that we are not providing 28 by 28, but we are providing 64 by 64 image. Only one image. This means that only one image. And here we have the three channels supply. Okay, because the convolution 2D works on three channels. Here are the filters. Remember that we already set the filters by 1. Okay. Kernel size, remember we already set the kernel size 8 by 8. Now input shape, remember that our input shape is here. So here is the input of 164. Okay. We don't use the bias for some reason, I will explain. But activation function we are gonna ReLU. ReLU means that if the number is greater than 0, let it pass. If the number is a negative number, change it to 0. Okay. Now the weights, as I said before, the weights must be calculated by the convolution neural network by itself during the training. But for the example, for the sake of simplicity, we already prepare our filter, plus filter, and we provide these filter weights here. For the moment, I put the padding valid. It means that I will not use padding. Stride is 1, 1 means that 1 column at a time, 1 row at a time. Now, at the end of this convolutional 2D, I provide the image matrix to work on with it. Now, I will run it. Look at that the feature map shape is 1 because we only one image and at the result 1 feature map. And it is 57 by 57, as we know that if it is the valid padding, it will be less than the input size of the image, 64 by 64, we know. And 1, it gives us the feature map 3 shape because it will be only one feature map in the end. When we look at the image matrix here. You see that we provided that image to the layer. And layer, before applying this, you might remember that we already apply feature map 1 and feature map 2 in Python. We already created by ourselves as a function. Remember that? In the second video, we apply and implement all these ideas in Python, and we found out feature map 1 and feature map 2 by applying two kinds of convolution. If you go down again and continue with the convolution 2D, you see that it is feature map 1 and it's the feature map 2. This feature map 3 comes from the result of the convolutional 2D of the Keras library. So you notice that our calculation for the feature map 2 is exactly the same with feature map 3. What we have done in the second video, in the previous video, exactly the same how the convolutional 2D layer works in Keras. Here I would like to show that you can write the convolution 2D layer in Python with applying all the concepts like padding, stride, convolution, element-wise multiplication, summation, all of them in Python, and you will end up with the same, exact the same solution or the feature map with the convolution 2D in Keras. So you would understand that actually convolution in Keras is not different than what you know as a concept. Okay, so I will make you comfortable if you like. For example, you can here increment the number of, for example, filters. You can make the number of filters 10, and you would see that in the end we will end up with the 10 different features because it will come from each filter. Also, you can apply the other ideas, for example, into the R loop here. In that loop, the stride is 1, so it's increasing row and column by 1. But in the loop, you can apply here, you can use the while loop here, and you can increment the column and the row by any number, so you can change the stride. Or as I showed you at the beginning of the coding, you can basically apply the padding here. You can apply the padding to the original image matrix, one padding, and you can simulate the padding same in that loop. So it's up to you to implement all these into the loops that we have already done. But you might be confident now understanding how the convolutional 2D, because in previous two videos we already implement it in Python, and this is the proof that feature map 2 is exactly the same with feature map 3. Alright, so how can you move on? Actually, you can create a circle filter and convolve it with the test images, and you can change the code that you can add the padding and stride explicitly into the loop. Okay, so you can change this loop here by just adding the stride and padding variables parameters here. So it's up to you. I hope that at the end of these three videos, now it's very easy to understand how convolution 2D works in general and in Keras. Thank you for watching.